their own reason. They're gonna get completely understanding if they walk away after hearing
the Yeah, for real, man. He asked it for a scripture. Yeah, it's really.
You don't know nothing yet, fool.
Shit. It's
alright. That's, I guess, that's all we want.
But they see us out here, though. You know what I mean? They try to, I don't know how you equate us with the church. That is crazy. It's the only real church is right here. We the only ones that have the truth. We can say that in all confidence. Okay? Because first of all, the churches, everything they do is all pagan from top to bottom. They all celebrate Christmas. And Christmas is like literally the birthday of Satan, well, Baal, not Satan, a Baal, of the fucking devil. You know what I mean? It's literally, that's what the pagans worship. That's what they was at. The pagans celebrated Christmas. That was never one of our traditions. They celebrate Easter. And Easter is blatant with the name. Because the name Easter itself comes from a Norse goddess. Easter is the name of a Norse goddess. But yet y'all celebrate Easter. How the hell is that so-called Christian? When it's the name is the name of a Norse goddess. Does that make any fucking sense? And they'll sit and try to justify it. Like, no, it doesn't really mean that. What does it mean then, bitch? Explain it. But you deserve to get smacked, bro, talking that shit. You do James White and all them apologetics, all them faggots. They all celebrate Christmas and Easter. You know what I mean? And they think they all holier than now. They think they better than everybody. Here it is, they're celebrating fucking Christmas and Easter. Just a bunch of faggot ass bitches.
Here you go, this is Isaiah 29:10. For the Lord, say yourselves and wonder. Cry ye out and cry. They are drunken, but not with wine. They stagger, but not with strong drink. For the Lord hath poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep. And have closed your eyes, the prophets and your rulers, the seers have thee covered.
Yeah, because our people, they in a deep sleep, man. And that our people, they're comfortable living out here in this bullshit. They're comfortable being miserable, being broke, you know what I mean? They like it.
Locked in it, motherfucker.
Hell no, they stabbed their way out. It reminds me of them wicked ass Benjamites when they took the raped that woman. You remember that? And then they cut her up into pieces. Well, you know what I'm saying, but that's how wicked our people is. They're like, they just the grimiest of the grimiest. Yeah, that's what it is.
See, they ain't telling on him. He said, he ain't paid no fare, and then he got a fuck.
That might be Benjamin too. They tell you it ain't that Benjamin spirit.
Yeah, the vision of all is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed.
Yeah, you just felt the spirit of the death walk by. Whew. Damn, that's the spirit too, because you just read that again from the top. What did it say?
Isaiah 29:10. For the Lord hath poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep.
Deep sleep. They gone, man. And a coma. Like you said, they're zombies.
He have closed your eyes. The prophets and your rulers, the seers, hath he covered.
What is that? Their cerebral cortex ain't functioning, bro.
Right.
Their pineal gland done got calcified.
female been removed.
Them been removed. That shit is fossilized, bro.
Right, in a museum somewhere in glass. Shit. These motherfuckers is something else.
Gone.
And the vision of all is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed.
Okay, this book, you're right. But hold up, but we supposed to love everybody, right?
Oh shit.
But these motherfuckers right here, you gonna tell me the Lord loves them?
Oh. Which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, read this, I pray thee. And he said, I cannot, for it is sealed. And the book is delivered to him that is not learned, saying, read this, I pray thee. And he said, I am not learned. Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth, and with their lips do honor me. Give me a scripture. Can I have a scripture now?
Yeah, with their lips they honor me. Right. Yeah, right. Give me a blessing.
Right.
And we don't know, they might be sincere, they might not be, but that's how they be though. You know what I mean? They always trying to, with their mouth, they honor the Lord, but with their heart's far from them. Like your boy, Anthony, what's his name? The kid keep coming up here. He said his name was Timothy.
Big boy, Timothy.
Yeah, Timothy. Cause he's out here, cause as soon as he seen a big old fat ass, he left. He went up and talked to her instead of us. That was the Lord that brought that fat ass out here. Hey, we gotta get Revelation 5. Alright.
For as wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth and with their lips do honor me, but have removed their heart far from me, and their fear toward me is taught by precepts
of men. Right, all that bullshit they talking about. Oh, like your dude Timothy was talking about the precepts of men. What was he saying? We already in the kingdom with kings right now and all this. Like, you crazy, bro.
Yeah, it gets worse. You keep hearing new shit all the time, man.
And they believe
just
that,
like
too.
Just like the nigga said that the Lord said, go out and teach that the Lord is
mad. Oh, he did say that.
That's some fucked out shit, man.
He said that was the only way people will believe.
Oh, that's
he do best with me. Oh, I thought. Hey, get that Revelation 5 where it's talking about the seals of Judah and all that.
Revelation 5.
Because you know Isaiah was talking about how they gave the Israel got the spirit of blindness that they can't see, and it talked about the seals, right? But this goes into that.
Revelation 5:1, and I saw
on
the right hand of him that sat on the throne,
a book written. Oh, I saw on the right hand of him that sat on the throne. Who's sitting on the throne? The Most High. Who's on the right hand side of the Most High? Jehoshaphat, which disproves the Trinity. And James White and all them Christian faggots. Go ahead. Because faggots, all faggots. Faggots are a bundle of sticks that gets burned up.
James White still retreating.
He been retreated. Hey, that. Well, you can't run from the missiles, bro. Go ahead.
On the backside seal was seven seals. And I saw a strong hand.
And it said that the book was sealed with seven seals. That's talking about this word, these scriptures. Go ahead. That sub place?
I don't know.
Have you ever heard of Jimmy John's?
No. There's some down there, ain't it?
This one down there.
Yeah.
Here.
They everywhere. That's like that new thing.
That's his name. Ain't that your real name?
Yeah, that's my real name.
That's his real name.
Like P-R-O-P-H-E-T, not.
Come on.
My mom's at home.
Is he not too
old? Last I heard, no. Last I heard of the life, he graduated. Just like I did after being graduated.
Working there?
Last day was like
Your mom still teaching you that black conscious stuff. Your mom still teaching you that black conscious stuff.
Yeah.
You know she wrong about everything, right?
Okay, you're...
I'm talking about black, that black conscious she teaching
you. What an honest opinion.
Yeah.
You insulted my mother, right?
Right, but you the man. You're a man, though.
I mean, I'm a man.
That's what I'm talking
about.
Well, you know, so if she don't...
I mean...
So you accept wisdom from someone that's teaching you something that ain't, that's false?
Actually...
You know what I'm saying?
My personal opinion.
What?
Aside from the whole Bible.
Like, give us an example of what she teaches you. What she told you. Black conscience. Egypt. Ancient Egypt.
That we're living in body, meant to God. Nothing about ancient
Egypt. I know.
Yeah.
Okay, stuff.
Yes, she got it.
She still got the one dreadlocks. She covered.
Nah, but my personal opinion is that basically this is all like different sides of the same stuff.
Say it again.
Everything, beliefs, is all the same size of different, or rather different sides of the same stuff.
Now, you see how the black conscience, they say things to make it sound deep, you know?
Okay, let me put it this way.
You hear what you're saying, though?
Yeah, I hear. But let me explain why.
You probably sweat like Jesus.
No, I'm just tired.
You sweat like hell,
I
man.
Didn't wake up until 3, but I've been going around downtown looking for some food. Right. So, I will not disclose that information anymore. They cannot find me, and I would like it to remain that way. I find them.
What you hear wrong is hide.
Oh, no, I don't hide.
Anyway, let's get back to what you know.
Anyway, it's all the same size. And basically that ball is like people's need to believe in
something. What's your nationality? How are your nationality?
My nationality is American, but I'm also Nigerian.
We're all people. You an Israelite. Those names, African American, Nigerian. No, you're one of them too.
Oh God, no.
Oh God, no. Right. Alright. Oh God, no.
I mean,
what God?
Oh God, no. Oh God, no. He said, oh God, no.
Term of expression.
Right, of course. And you're speaking your heart.
It doesn't mean I mean it.
Right?
No.
But well, there's no such thing as a Nigeria. It's just a Latin.
I'm
that's a Latin
have to stop
word.
You guys right here.
Is it really?
Yeah, it means
Nigeria.
Black.
Nigeria.
It means nigger. It means black. That's a Latin word.
Wasn't America named after a white man?
America was named after
America Vespucci. No,
yes.
And Africa.
Yeah. Africa also.
Africa too. Africa was named after a white man.
So you're a white man's property. Then they did that.
See, that's why we're out here to just give people an example of how to give you a little info so you know who you are. See, now that we told you you're an Israelite, you can go on and say I'm African American Nigerian or you want that. Because the Lord's not coming to save Nigerians nor African Americans. He's coming to save Israelites. You hear me?
That's
those
an
names
actual
you just said, names that these goddamn devils gave to us. Those are names they gave to us, so we won't know who we are.
Are you all?
Because power is within, you know, knowledge, you know.
Are you Hebrew Israelites?
Oh, who?
We're
Hebrew Israelites, right? You are a Hebrew Israelite. Your mom is a Hebrew Israelite. You hear me?
Yeah.
We're not niggas.
Oh, man.
African American? Lord have me stop you for a reason, though.
My own cousin?
Your own cousin start nodding to the
hood.
No. You don't like that, do you? Are you rejecting it? Being called an Israelite?
I'm not rejecting it.
Yashuala? You refusing being called Yashuala?
Okay, here we go.
You know?
Hey, let me give you a scripture real quick, though. See what the scriptures say about the Israelite. Just real quick, let me get this.
I'm already cutting everybody
the
off.
The truth is the truth. No, cut them up as far as when you want to give knowledge and people want to vomit their madness on you. You know?
But check this out.
If I was a Satanist or a devil worship, you going to be down because I made it sound good.
It's all something to believe in, right?
Yeah, right.
You know what I mean?
But I made it sound good, though.
Different strokes for different folks.
And that's what all that black consciousness stuff is all about. Satanism. It's root of Satanism.
Actually, a lot of them top dudes, though, like the Comedians, they Freemasons.
I never actually did say what I think about all this.
This
and that.
Hey, let me hit you with a scripture about Israel, though. Deuteronomy 7:6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Above all people. That's us. The Israelites, we are above all people. Like the scripture says, we are a special people. We are special. You can see that. I mean, we're a bunch of dumbasses. You know, we all envy into all kinds of madness, but you can still see we're a special people. You know? That's the benefits of being an Israelite. That you're the Lord's people. You're his chosen people. You know? And there's a lot of nations on this earth, but the Lord, like everybody, has a lot of this and that. But amongst that lot of this and that, you got a favor. This is the favor of the Lord's people. This is the favor. And all the mother motherfuckers ain't nothing but heathens. Slaves.
That's why you're around heathens, your spirits can't connect. You know what I mean?
That's right.
That is
Bay.
I can't get on that bus.
You're an Israelite.
That was Bay. I don't think y'all understand.
That was
Bay.
That's Bay.
Your girl?
About to get off the bus.
Go boo.
Kinda. I just like going around talking to random bus drivers.
She one of them good looking drivers?
Yeah.
There's a few of them, bro. One of them, I be seeing her, she likes me.
Light-skinned?
Yeah.
Light-skinned has like a ponytail.
I be getting on the bus sometimes, bro.
Uh-huh.
I be telling her. That was my girl, I gave her a blessing one day on campus.
Yeah.
You know she an Israelite.
Yeah,
she an Israelite, bro.
Yeah, I think
you don't know about how the Israel scattered among all nations. You didn't know that. You know your skin color doesn't determine your nationality and where you come from. That's one of those mysteries. So we coming out with mysteries. All these other fools, they ain't got no mysteries.
Oh, this is gonna be wild.
We get crazy, bro. We get bugged out. We'll bug you out.
Oh no, I'm just like extremely interested to like see exactly how much I know versus how much I think.
Well, you know.
I got a scripture for that,
you know,
one too.
You're still young, you know. You're still a young man, you don't know nothing. You know, you're in the world, in this world, you're gonna be making all kinds of mistakes, fucking up, but you're not listening. And that's our people. They don't wanna take instructions, so they wanna find their own way, you know.
Yep,
on that way, they're fucking up.
Oh, what about that way? That's at Matthew 7, the straight way.
Oh, yeah, right. Yeah, that's that straight way we can. The straight way that you can explain. Yeah, you said
mysteries,
though.
I never said anything about this.
Not me.
Okay. That scripture, though. Are you guys, like, filming me?
Now, you know, I don't know if you're on camera or not.
You on camera?
You all right. Ain't nobody even watching.
What, you want to be a star?
You know, the last time I heard that question being asked. My name's not Prophet. I swear to God, my name's not Prophet.
His name is William.
William?
Yep. There we go.
And there you go, but look, real quick.
I don't like using my government name. I don't care. So, like, when people say my name's Prophet, I need to go by Xavier, William,
or Xavier. I got scripture. 1 John 2:20. But ye have an unction from the Holy One, and ye know all things. You trying to figure out how much you know? The scriptures say we know all things. When the Spirit's dealing with you, the Lord just beams everything right into your mind,
right.
To your soul.
But I got to read this real quick, just 2 Ezra 12:37. Therefore write all these things that thou hast seen in a book, and hide them, and teach them to the wise of the people. Not everybody, but to the wise of the people.
Yeah, because this ain't for everybody.
Right. Whose hearts thou knowest may comprehend and keep these secrets.
Well, we're dealing with secrets.
That's bad,
with
man.
Mysteries.
That's bad.
We go into topics people. like when we start talking about UFOs or something, most the average person can't comprehend that.
You believe in UFOs? You ever seen one? UFO, flying saucers. Aliens.
Again, I'm only.
No, I mean, no, I ain't doing your star master. believe in it or not, you know, whether you don't.
I'm not even going to respond to that.
Okay, that's good. That's
okay. That was like always a topic of interest for me, because like I said,
I'm only here to listen.
Hey, it's good to listen, bro.
That's good, because that's a wise man that keeps his mouth shut. That's actually a wise man. You know, that can keep his mouth shut.
Let me get that. What's that scripture? That's Ecclesiastes.
Keep your mouth shut.
5.
I'm thinking 4 or 5. You got 4 or 5.
No,
I'm thinking of. Yeah. Wait a minute. You think of apocryphal?
Yeah.
I'm thinking of. Hold on. Let me get this. Yeah, that's bad.
And that 25. That's 20. I mean, it's 25.
Let me read this. Ecclesiastes 5.
Here we go.
Ecclesiastes 5:1. Keep thy foot when thou goest to the house of the Most High, and be more ready to hear than to give the sacrifice to fools. Sacrifice to fools, you know, with their manners, you know.
Before they even listen to what we got to say, they assume they know what we're talking about. You know, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, blah, blah.
You know what I mean? That's all I hear.
All right.
And they'll curse us out.
I'm sorry. Maybe I should start asking questions. I don't get it. And you're gonna make me admit this. Let me ask you, I don't know what the hell you're talking about. Let me be straight honest with you.
No, I know.
And by that, I mean, I wanna know, like, the basis of your religion. Who's the founder, rather, like, who's actually rediscovered this information since it's already been discovered before.
We just brought that out. Revelation.
How did these tribes come about?
That's
how did you know that it was Israelites? Right.
Go back to Revelation 5.
These tribes is mentioned in the Bible.
Who's the prophet that actually, like, came out?
Jehoshaphat.
It's who the world ignorantly calls Jesus. You heard of that. Jesus. But his name isn't Jesus.
I call him Jesus.
Dang his name. That's not his name.
His name is Jehoshaphat.
Right.
Jehoshaphat.
It's the ancient Hebrew pronunciation.
Right.
Jehoshaphat. We need to get to Revelation 5.
Doesn't that mean, like, how we know it?
And be more ready to hear than to give the sacrifice of fools, for they consider not that they do evil. Be not rash with thy mouth, and let not thy heart be hasty to utter anything before the Most High.
That's what most of our people do. They're very rash with their mouth.
I honestly want to know how safe this is.
What's that?
I honestly want to know how safe this is.
Not stable at all.
Yeah, I wouldn't trust that shit.
Yeah,
if you fall, I'm gonna laugh.
I give it like 3 to 5 minutes. Put some money on it for extra money.
Yeah, that's just shit they just do just to spend
money. Man, they tearing up the whole damn city. Bro.
He's not wrong.
Rock Street on the east side been one lane for like 5 years. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Revelation 5.
Oh, Bexley?
Yeah. They always fucking that shit up. It's always jammed. Always been rush hour.
The Jews, man, flushing shit down the toilet. It's like clogging that shit up, man. Yeah. Hey, like baby parts in.
Okay, now I have another question. What's the difference between the Hebrew Israelite and the Jew?
They're Hebrew Edomites and we're Hebrew Israelites. Because we're related, going back thousands of years.
Wait, so what's an Edomite?
That's
your
enemy.
That's
the so-called white man.
Okay, so Edomite.
Edomite.
I never call them Edomites. I mean, the way y'all make them sound like they're like, they came from like the bottom of Edomite.
Well, that's why.
Yeah. You're right.
They came out the asshole. Yeah.
Look, I know it's Edomites, but I'm going to just call them Edomites. Why Edomites are enemies?
What is that? That's bad right there. I like that.
Hey, they like that too.
See, that's why we're peculiar, strange people that we come up with things like that.
I mean, Edomites, enemies, come on.
Yeah. But they're, those Jews, they're identity thieves. They're calling themselves what we are.
Even though in secret, they teach their people who they really are. Because we've had them admit it to us. He got a book written by a Jew when they tell you that who the real Edomites are.
Let me get that book, man.
You got it on you?
Yeah.
That's a really good book.
Yeah. Who is Edom?
Is that on there? I can't see shit. That's a really good book. Y'all should order that book.
That's all.
Where'd you get it? Amazon?
Yeah.
So basically what y'all just said, like,
if
What she said? I wouldn't even hear what she said.
She said, why they always build? I mean, why they always destroy? They say they build, but they really destroy.
Oh, really? I mean, they destroyed everything when they poured the concrete and built all these buildings. This right here used to be beautiful forest right here. The Scioto River used to be beautiful, clean. You used to be able to drink. Yeah, drink.
You know, when I can see that around, there's a problem.
Yeah, and it stinks bad. We be going down there all the time. It stinks. You know what I mean? Hey, yeah, read that Revelation 5, Bill. We're going to show you the secret.
Revelation 5 and 1. And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne of the book, written with on and on the backside, sealed with seven seals. And I saw
it. It said it was a book sealed with seven seals. Talking about these scriptures. Go ahead. And the word, the number seven, represents completion. That's why you got 7 days in a week. Is that the number seven, you know, that lucky number seven, right?
How do I feel about 5%?
Man, they come out with a little bit of truth and a whole lot of lies. You know what I mean? That's like that Wu-Tang shit. A lot of them was 5%. Yeah, it's a hustle. They get to sell books. You know what I mean? A lot of the stuff they sounds good. And they do bring out a lot of good information. But when it comes to the Bible, though, they don't know what they're talking about. Go ahead and read this.
I saw an angel complaining with a loud voice. Who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seven seals?
Right, who is worthy to open this book and loose the seals? Meaning, to loose the seals, we want to be able to break it down and explain it. To be able to decode decode the code. Go ahead.
And no man in heaven, nor in earth, neither under earth, was able to open the book, neither to look thereon.
So nobody was able to loose the seals of the book except for who?
And I wept much because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. And one of the elders said unto me, weep not, behold, the lion of the tribe of Judah.
The lion of the tribe of Judah, he called?
The root of David.
The root of David. Go ahead.
I prevailed to open the book and to loose the seven seals thereof. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne, and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders stood a lamb that had been slain, even having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of the Most High, sent forth into all the earth.
All right, that's the point, though. Because Yahawashah, he's the lamb, right? He's that lion from the tribe of Judah. He's the one, the lion of the tribe of Judah, is the one that prevailed to open his book. And then another good point is all these churches, these preachers, if you ask them if they're an Israelite from the tribe of Judah, they'll say no. So that tells you that they don't know the book then. Because it tells you it was Judas who was able to loose the seal and tell us, you know, all the mystery.
Okay, so where did all that come from?
It's all scriptural. You can tell by the spirit that all these people are Israelites on that side. And you can't even fit all the Israelites on one side, but through the spirit, we get the scriptures, you can prove that all these people are Israelites.
So for any actual people in the continent or the landmass that is known Europeanly as Africa, are there any Israelites in there?
Of course. They're among all nations.
Okay, well, since they're amongst all nations, well, actually, you did say that you can't fit all the tribes.
Yeah. I mean, it's just a...
So does the tribes have, like, many tribes?
Tribes are like nations.
This is one nation. But within this nation, we have 12 tribes, but the Lord scattered these 12 tribes from the four corners of the earth. So we are living amongst everybody. And those living amongst everybody, they don't know that they're Israelites. You know?
Because you're living amongst everybody.
Right, because you're living, you're living on their culture. Those other heathen's culture, like Lotto's, like in the Sudan. Oh man, the Sudan, that's some sick ass practices they do, man. And they don't know.
Aren't men fucking other men there?
Oh, yeah, that's a common practice within Hamite nations.
Yeah, true.
You know, that's a common practice, that homosexual. That's what
the first, that's why them jakes on the west coast of Africa, they put homosexuals to death because a lot of them are Israelites. Yeah. On the west coast of Africa, a lot of, this is all the Israelites over there.
So, wait, I'm sorry, I'm confused. Is the west Israelites, are they the ones putting them to death or being put to death?
No, of course. They don't like faggots over there in Africa.
I'm so confused. Wait. So, the Israelites who are putting the people over there to death,
but they don't know they're Israelites.
So, like, they're actually Israelites. That's what I'm trying to ask.
Right. Well, we don't know unless they're through the spirit, though. You watch videos of, YouTube is bad. That's the thing about the internet, man. You can actually go to those places about physical being.
Yeah.
Hit up the videos and you just watch what's going on with most of people. But you can tell it's a lot of through the spirit that they're Israelites. Just through the eyes, you can tell somebody's a brother. just through looking through somebody's eyes.
That's the only way you're going to know, really.
Just the same. The eyes is the window to the soul.
Yeah.
You heard that before. Sure, you have. That's common with some people.
But here, I got a scripture for you to clear it up. Look. Amos. Oh, my God. Good boy. I see you looking at this. Oh, my goodness. Look.
So, how long do y'all think it'll take for me to get rejected by her? Rejected.
Oh, it's going to take a long time. But you might fall, and she might take you long. Come on, baby. You got some wheels too? Come on, baby. You can scoot around it.
I see him flying on that damn thing too. Going like 50 miles an hour on that thing. Them big ass wheels.
Well, you know, when you apply physics and then like you also apply position. Followed by like,
Hey, let me read the scripture for you though.
Shit.
You ain't allowed to go nowhere yet. Listen. Science means knowledge. Look. Amos 9 and 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord God are upon this, let me read this. Behold, the eyes of the Lord God are upon this sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it off the face of the earth, saving, I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, save the Lord.
The sinful kingdom is America.
Yep, it's America's a sinful kingdom.
And that's what we are here for.
Is it a sinful kingdom, or is it the belly of the beast?
It's both.
America got many names. We got a lot of names. Babylon, right. Egypt, Rome,
Idumea,
Sodom, Gomorrah.
Right. You know what I mean?
But this is the point right here.
The whore,
the great whore.
Right.
The toilet.
That belongs to the statue.
A pile of shit. You say a Statue of Liberty?
Yeah.
Unless it's a transvestite.
That's what Statue of Liberty is.
And it represents actually Sol Invictus
to
some guys. Let me read this for you.
That's what America's all about, turning all these men into homosexuals. Sodomites. Turn all the women into lesbians. That was the spirit, how they came out like that. That was an example.
I just want the food, man.
Here's some food right here. Go a sandwich. Don't choke on it. For lo.
You ain't got no pork on it, do you?
Oh, we gotta get him some gerbers first.
Boy, you don't beef. We don't eat pork.
That's right.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, the Bible says don't eat pork. But look at this. For lo, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel among all nations.
For lo, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel.
Among all nations.
You know my system?
Like a
sift
corn.
It's like when you like basically, it's like when you like look for diamonds. And
separate.
So
a gold and stuff, like, yeah.
Separation.
You said you got like this, like here it said, I will sift the house of Israel among all nations.
Latinos? Hey, y'all Israelite, man. Y'all all Israelites. They know now.
Let me read the scripture.
They know now. That's why we come out here, so that all people know these things.
Yeah, you gotta tell, they don't know. They think they Mexicano, La Raza, and all that madness. Cause they call themselves La Raza. It's already in the spirit. They say La Raza means the race. They think they the head race. That's already in their spirit, you know what I mean? Because they know they're Jake.
Right?
Huh?
You realize that's a gang, right?
Well, what? No, it's just not a gang. It's more of a movement, what they call it. La Raza. You know what I mean?
They
call themselves La Raza all over the place. It just means the race. But let me finish the scripture, though. For lo,
you know what he's reading. You know about sifting. About sifting is like another word for separation.
Yeah, separation.
Yeah.
A lot of tedious separation, though.
For lo, I will command and sift the house of Israel among all nations like a corn is sifted in its seed, yet shall not the least grain fall upon the earth. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword.
I love the scripture that for that part right there.
Which okay. Say the evil shall not overtake nor prevent it.
Separating the evil from the wicked.
Yep.
He's separating, you know? That's a bad scripture because it's separating us from the wicked nations and it's separating the wicked from amongst our nations.
Yep.
That's a double sifting. Twofold.
Yep. That's a twofer.
That's beautiful, man.
You get a twofer on that one, boy.
Yep.
Yeah, because most of our people, two-thirds of our people got to die. They just gotta go. They got. They just need to perish.
Oh wow.
Which, look, here, let me just get it, man.
They gotta. Wow. They gotta.
You know,
fuck,
we ain't reading nothing from our hearts, man. We ain't speaking from our hearts.
I mean, they ain't no good. But, like, I'm just thinking about the sandwich, and then he over here talking about dying.
He gave you some meat.
I gave you some meat.
Well, he accidentally gave you some meat. And you choking it up.
I haven't eaten in 2 days.
Now, That wasn't really meat. That was like one of them. Protein shake. I put it in the blender first.
How long are you guys out here?
Let me read this for you. 13. This is Zechariah 13 and 8. Listen. And it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die.
Yep.
I just read a scripture in the Bible. I ain't make that up, did I?
That actually makes sense.
Bruh.
I'm not opposed to that.
The majority of our people are wicked as hell, man. They gotta fucking go. They got nothing good to contribute to nothing. They gotta go.
That's why we're giving you this wisdom, because the Lord's talking to you. He's telling you to wake up. You know?
You wanna like give me some of that wisdom right there and just pull it out of your bag so I can have some.
Oh,
because physically I'm actually malnourished.
Now that
helps
you
out. Yes.
I just got back.
Come on.
Shit, man. What are you?
Well,
you already ate here.
Hold on. Let me get the scripture for you, bro.
Boy. Sir, man.
You said you was hungry.
I mean malnourishment.
Now, you know, scripture say man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of the Most High. The Lord fasted for 40 days.
Ooh, can you imagine that?
And then Satan came up and said, if you the son of God, why don't you turn that rock into a loaf of bread?
Call him a weak moment.
And then he cursed out Satan. He wasn't weak, though.
Right.
He said, man shall not live by bread alone.
Did he actually curse out Satan?
Curse his ass out. Yeah, he was good.
Fuck you. Like, for real, wasn't
he? We cursed him out. He rebuked him.
He said, you a little bitch. That's why you're my dad. We beat you down.
But the Lord did talk like that, though.
He talked me.
But back in them days, they the word bitches in the Bible, they call women dogs through the Bible. You're allowed to use so-called cuss words. There's no laws in the Bible that says you ain't allowed to cuss. And those are manly words, you know what I mean? That's how the way a man speaks. A man don't talk like a woman. Now, I wouldn't expect a woman to come up here using all that foul language.
You know what I mean?
Because you got scriptures where Paul was calling people effeminate. He said, y'all can't be all effeminate. Acting like, pretty much saying y'all act like little faggot bitches and stuff. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Listen to this.
Luke 19 and 21.
And this is the Lord himself.
For I fear thee, because thou art an austere man.
You know what austere means?
Like austerity measures? Austere means...
Check it out. Okay, Google now.
Oh, God.
Okay, Google now. My phone fucked it up, man.
I got a dictionary in my book.
Okay, Google now. Look up the word austerity. I dropped my phone in water.
Austerity. Sternness is severity of manner or attitude.
Hear it? Sternness and severity.
Austere. Sternness or severity of manner or attitude. Extreme plainness and simplicity of style and appearance.
The Lord was austere.
Conditions characterized by severity, sternness.
Stern. The Lord was not playing games with people. He meant business. You know what I mean? The Lord was not fucking around. It's like, you better do what he says. You know what I mean?
That's right.
That's why, I mean, it's not a wise thing to disobey the Lord. Where are you with all these tall women? One of them Amazonian women. Could be, bro. This is training.
There's a gym right there. There's a gym right there, too.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it is. You see all kind of weird stuff in there, I bet.
It's freak nature, man. This is freak. Wait, I just had that scripture.
Come on.
Bro, we got scriptures.
I know y'all got scriptures for days, but
here you go.
We got scriptures infinite.
Getting stuck down here, bro. I'll drop you off.
I mean, Revelation. If you do that, I'm gonna make you take me
to Mr. Peter. I'll take you, man. You know, like I said, I knew you was a baby, man. I just whooped your ass when you used to fuck up.
What?
You don't remember, though. I'm surprised you don't remember that. I used to babysit him all the time, man.
For real?
Somebody, he was my kid's cousin, you know? They were some bad motherfuckers when they got together. All of them, man.
Oh, shit.
You know, I let them play. I let, you know, always, you know, I ain't like a woman. A woman would be like, oh, you playing too rough. You know, I used to let them play. Act crazy, man.
That's how you do it.
For real, this is Revelation 11 and 8.
Yeah, it's always the woman got to ruin the fun.
Right, right. And their dead bodies shall lie in the streets of the great city, which spiritually is called... You hear that? It's crazy.
You said yes?
I don't know, man. Probably.
Oh, man. But we get it all
people
day long,
though. People hate the Lord,
though,
man. People hate the Lord, man.
Jesus curses.
She's having such a good
day. Now, I feel sorry for the way the rest of her day. Her day is not going to end. Like, bro, last week, woman came up Skyfall on a bike. Pow!
Right here.
Face plant right to the fucking concrete, right in front of us.
That crazy bitch right there.
She got up, she stood up, her glasses was all crooked. You know what I mean? Who?
Oh, it is too.
That's
the same shit.
That's Legion.
That's the same shit. And their dead bodies should lie in the street of the great city.
The one way in the back.
It's called Sodom and Egypt.
Back this way. No, right here, with the hoodie.
Right there.
Last week she was possessed by demons or something. She was howling. I don't know how to explain it. She was like howling and screaming and screeching.
I love them days like we had last week.
Oh, that was amazing.
I have like 10 to 15 minutes.
That was amazing.
What's good?
Wait, y'all gonna be here another 10 to 15 minutes?
Probably.
Okay, I'll be right back.
All right. Woo! How you doing, brother? You know? I said, how you doing, brother? Wasn't rude. Wasn't ignorant motherfucker.
No, he ain't doing too good. Check it out.
Yeah, he's doing bad. Now he knows he's doing worse. It's justified why he's doing bad. Because you can't be brotherly back to a brother.
It's your boy.
Well, I knew he was going to sneak out of here. I knew he was trying to sneak out of here.
You don't think he's coming back?
I hope he does, but...
Dad, he was gone on that skateboard.
He was raised by his mom, man. His mom was in trouble as fuck. Raised by his mom. He was trying to send him to school to white schools. And shit kept moving around trying to send him to the more the schools would have more white people. See, he all went down the street already. That motherfucker was gone.
He was gone. That's why the first time I seen him.
He said it was physics.
Said something about the ball, everything
yeah.
is a ball in itself.
And, all right, now he said, there he is. He had it worked out in his head.
Yeah, right. He practiced it. He rehearsed it. But he didn't get Chester really breaking out.
Yeah, because you got a lot of people to be like, well, all the religions on earth all basically mean the same thing. No, they don't, because the Bible tells you the hell with all those heathen nations and their practices. It actually tells us that if you follow their ways, you're supposed to get stones until you die.
Right.
So how is that the same as anything else? So you're supposed to get stoned to death for following. How is that in any way related? That don't make no damn sense. We ain't out here yet, that new age bullshit, bro. That's that satanic doctrine. Where they take all the religions of the world and mix them all together into a cauldron of shit, you know what I mean? Because that's what Christianity is. Christianity is not even biblical, it's a mixture of all the heathen customs put together. Proof is what? They celebrate Christmas. Christmas was a practice, was a holiday of the ancient Romans. The Canaanites celebrate Christmas too. Then you got Easter, you know, that named after a Norse goddess. So there's a mixture right there. They're taking names from different cultures and mixing it all together in the church. See how they do that? And then they take the Christmas tree and then they throw that in there. That's part of that mixture of the heathenism. Go ahead.
Yeah,
Isaiah 45:5. To whom will he liken me and make me equal and compare me that he may be like?
Yeah, who you gonna compare the Most High to? Oh, the scripture says Yahweh is one. Oh, let me get that. Let me get that. There's only one. Is there more to that?
That's a little grimy nigga.
Yeah, I got you. No, let me get this. If you want it, you can read it. Deuteronomy 6:4. Actually. Yeah, let me read it. Deuteronomy 6:4. Hear, O Israel, Yahweh Elohayanawa is one Yahweh. Really, that's what it says. Well, in the English it says, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. But really, it don't say Lord. It only says that in the English Bible. You read the Hebrew Bible, it says Yahweh is one. Okay? He is one. There's only one. Oh, go ahead.
Remember this? Remember the former things of old, for I am God, and there is none else. I am God, and there is none like me.
There is none like him. Actually, you can believe in aspects of Buddhism and Hinduism, because it's all reaching towards the same spiritual goal. You hear him say that, right? It's all the same thing. You believe in something. You know what I mean? It's all the same. But it's not the same. It's totally fucking different.
That's what they say, too.
They don't say that. You know what I mean? That's popular.
Yeah, I mean, it's a difference.
They'll say it's all different aspects of the same God. But that's not true at all. There's the other one that says there is none besides that. Isaiah 34.
How do you deal with this here?
So, what,
believe. Isaiah 34, seek ye. Is that the one? No, that's not the one, but I'll read it anyway. Isaiah 34:16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord. Actually says, seek ye out of the book of Yahweh. And read, no one of these shall fail, none shall want her mate. From my mouth it hath commanded, and his spirit it hath gathered them. So you can't mate the Bible with the Quran and be like, see, it's basically the same thing. You can't do that. You can't mix this with the Mahabharata and all the, with the Iliad and the Odyssey. Nah, you cannot mate this book with no other book. I was arguing with this fool for the past 2 days over that Egypt shit, man. He's trying to tell me that there was no proof. He tried to say they didn't have no DNA evidence that that the Israelites built the pyramids and all that.
Isaiah 42:8. I am Yahweh, that is my name, and my glory was not given to another. Neither my praise is great
to him. Right. It would not give us glory to another. So you cannot believe in whatever the hell you want and say it all means the same thing, basically. You can't do that. There is only one truth. And anything that is not of the truth is a lie. If you have 99% truth and 1% lies, you have 100% lies.
They don't have the nerve to say that your interpretation is correct and my interpretation is correct.
Yeah. Oh, we can, like your boy said earlier, we can agree to disagree. That's one of their favorite sayings. Agree to disagree. What was on None Beside Me? Which one is that? Did you already read that? I know it's in a popular scripture. I just can't think it, bro. Yeah, it does say it a lot. Oh, here we go. Isaiah 45:6. Oh, yeah. Isaiah 45. Oh, yeah. Yeah, get that. We read all Isaiah 45:7. I am the Lord. Isaiah 45:6 and 7. Check out your mirror right there.
cougar.
Isaiah 45, you got that? Yeah, you got to watch with your bags that work. But they get you, they slick with they shit.
You want 1 foot, Isaiah 45?
Yeah, Isaiah 45, 6, and then 7.
Okay. That they may know from the rising of the sun and from the west, that there is none beside me. I am the Lord, and there is none else.
There is none else. Keep going. The next one.
I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things.
Said, I, the Lord, do all these things. Says, he said, there's none. There's only one Lord. There's only one God. There's not a many gods, okay?
Well, there's many. We're gods.
Well, one heavenly, you know what I mean? One Yahweh, one creator. Did you just say that word God? Because really, the word God comes from the word good. Just like the word devil comes from the word evil. So there is only one that's good. Ain't that what the scripture said that? Let me get that. There's only one that's good, and that's the Most High.
Isaiah 32 and 39. See now that I, even I, am me, and there is no God with me. I kill and I make alive, I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand.
So he didn't say but actually though, you know what I'm saying, you can merge this with Buddhism and Hinduism and Muslims and all that. Nah, that's a good recipe for death. You know what I mean? A good recipe for a curse. That's your girl. You don't remember talking to her? She was cool. That girl right there, she came out and she was talking to us one day.
Oh, yeah, right. She was kind of like with us.
Yeah, she was cool though.
Yeah.
She looked cool. I'm going to get on the diet plan. It'll be all right. Stop being pork, bro. If all women stop being pork, man, that would cure a lot of their infirmities right there. They'd be overweight. I'm telling you, if you a woman, you watching this, you overweight, just stop eating pork. Right there, that's gonna help you a lot. You can start getting your figure back and all that. You know what I mean?
Take a while.
Then you might actually taste good.
Take a while.
You know what I mean? It might take a while. I mean,
have that patience.
You gotta be patient, but you stop it. You gotta eat right, okay? That's the key to physical health. You know, you gotta fucking eat right, obviously. You gotta do what the Lord commanded. The Lord put laws in the Bible for a reason. It's for your own well-being. That's why all my family, all the men on my dad's side of family died by the age of 50. Because they all ate fucking pork every goddamn day. Heart attack after heart attack after heart attack. You know what I mean? Just pork grease flowing through the veins and the arteries, clogging them up. Because you feel better when you eat right too, don't you? When you eating good food, you feel better. Like if I ever eat some, because I don't eat a lot of greasy food, but even these days if I eat some greasy ass french fries or something, which y'all hardly ever do, when I do it, bro, I be paying the price. I'm like, damn, that grease got me, son. You know what I mean? I can't handle grease no more because I'm so used to eating greens and shit.
True. Body rejection.
Yeah. Yeah, it don't belong in your body. All them vegetable oils and all that shit ain't good for you. That what they call that vegetable oil that you buy from the store and they cook the fries in? That shit is hell on your body, man. It's not natural. What you got? Oh, I don't know. I thought you was reading something. Yeah, whatever.
But it says it a lot.
Yeah, we can read it all.
It says Isaiah 44 and
8. Because he had to tell Israel back then. Like, look. Because he was telling, because the book of Isaiah is cursing out Israel because they following the ways of the heathen, right? Same with Jeremiah. Because that's why Isaiah said it, what, Isaiah 58? Lift up your voice like a trumpet and show my people their transgression. And what the main transgressions of our people is what? The spiritual adultery. They commit adultery against the Most High.
Isaiah 44:6. Thus saith Yahweh, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, Yahweh of hosts, I am the first, and I am the last. Besides me, there is no God.
He said, I am the first, I'm the last. Besides me, there is none.
And who, as I say, shall fall and shall declare, and set in order for me, since I have appointed the ancient people, and the things that are coming and shall come. Let them show unto them. Fear ye not, neither be afraid. Have not I told thee from that time, and I declared it, ye are even my witness. Is there a God besides me? Yea, there is no God, I know not any.
Right, because we witness the Lord's power. All the beliefs of the heathens are just that. They just the belief of a heathen. None of these heathen nations had the Most High come to the earth and then lead them through the Red Sea, split the Red Sea. He showed himself on Mount Sinai, spoke to the people. When did the Most High ever show himself to the heathens like that, bro? None of their false gods ever appeared to them. The only way them false gods ever appeared was in stone and wood. You know what I mean? The Most High actually came and saved us and delivered us out of the hands of the Egyptians. And countless times that he sent an angel to help us. Miranda, did not the Lord send an angel to help Hezekiah? You know what I mean? To help the Maccabees, he sent an angel. Hey, ain't that scripture too? We read it. Bro, a couple weeks ago, we was reading in the book of Judas. What's up, bro? And how that one dude told him about the Israelites, he's like, if their God is with them, you can't fuck with them.
Yeah, right.
Because they have a power that is actually with them. Unlike the heathens. Because the heathens don't have no power.
Oh, you don't.
Oh, shit. He done found some food already. That was quick, boy.
My man.
Exodus 15:11. Who is like unto thee, O Yahweh, among the gods? Who is like glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders?
Yeah, because them heathen nations, they ain't never seen the Most High. The Most High actually came to us and delivered us.
She
gone.
They hold a lot of water close to that shit. They hold their bodies full of what's not supposed to be toxins and sodium. Yeah. You know, you're supposed to be out exercising, sweating out. Sweating their balls. You're supposed to sweat toxins out.
Yeah. Plus they all eat pork and shit. You don't want to smell that when that sweats out.
You want to keep
it? Oh, don't worry. I wear a mask like when I make sure that sweats out.
That's a big thing with our people to eat pork though. You know what I mean? They love that shit. Now you see why all of our women are so overweight. You know what I mean? That's all they eat. Because if you follow the dietary laws in the Bible, you ain't gonna balloon up to 500.
She doesn't eat pork.
Well, there's other things too that you shouldn't eat.
There's a lot. There's more than just pork.
There's a lot of things you shouldn't be eating. Like crabs, lobster, shrimp, catfish.
Don't say chicken.
Nah, you ain't chicken, but you shouldn't eat too much
of it. Yeah.
You know what? You can't, but because they now passed that law.
Wait,
2 weeks ago. They ain't got a label of food GMO.
Oh, yeah.
Don't.
The GMO chicken.
Don't say turkey.
You can eat turkey.
Okay. Sweet. I got turkey stuff right here.
No, I mean, this is the unclean ass. Some thing be common sense, like catfish. You can't eat that, because what does a catfish do?
A catfish is like someone who's on the other side of the internet, like basically get into
it. He keeps the ocean, the river clean.
Oh,
they bottom feed all right.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, he's talking about a real catfish. He's talking about that new catfish. Y'all heard about the catfish and what they call it? Oh, cat, that's a new thing. Catfish. That's called catfishing or something.
Like, they can be like a speech tennis one. You can be like, God damn.
Hey, I saw a bad spirit. Right? This is a spiritual too, man. A tire commercial that came out, and they showing four women running in formation of four tires, right?
Oh, yeah.
And they mentioned the high, actually first the tires were men. And when they mentioned the tires can perform over high miles, then the tires turned into women. What? I was like, wow.
Are you serious?
Yeah. I just started watching some shit on the with the Olympics, man. The tire commercial came in.
Well, then they should let the women compete with the men then.
These women got miles.
Since they so much like mightier than men, they should like make the women race against men.
That's right. You're right.
Right?
Let them box against
Why ain't they got women boxing men?
They do.
And they probably do.
They really do.
I'm talking about the Olympics and, you know.
Yeah, they do.
Oh, yeah, why ain't they got women in the NFL?
Those are children. Them is children, though.
I want to see a woman halfback.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. A running back.
Middle linebacker.
Yeah, well, a linebacker? Boy, whoever is the running back that day is going to break the record.
He's going to break every record.
He's going to break all the records. And then the record ain't going to count. They was like...
Wait, are you talking about women hanging out with them?
Nah, your boy, he's always trying to mack on some women. Well, he's out here trying to hang some scriptures. He's sending a big booty came by, and he's like, I gotta go. No, dude will walk by.
Well, to be fair, Columbus is boring.
Very boring.
Okay, let me reiterate that. Columbus is boring as shit. I'm sorry.
Now
I'm not from this city, I'm from Chicago.
See, we make this shit hype out here just by us being here.
Well, so if you don't want something to do, you're going to be missing. You're going to be around people that are in trouble and shit like that. It's up to no good.
I don't want to do that.
And if you want to occupy your time, you'll have to spend money. You want to go to places have to spend money.
Or you can just have a skateboard and randomly get a bike.
Just ride a bike around.
See, what we do, this right here is exciting, though.
Doing stuff, and that's exercise. That's good.
Don't go to Goodell Park at the 12th.
Why is that? Homosexual?
No.
Orgies?
It's just me and those unsuspecting people.
Because that's a big time homosexual area up there. The short north. That's crazy.
Sometimes I don't feel too guilty about that.
I'm just saying, that's just crazy up there.
Oh, no. It's just like I ride very fast on my skateboard. Goodell Park is my testing area. It's for how fast I can go, so imagine that. After
we saw you floating down. It's floating.
Beginning at the giant jumbo wheels,
yeah,
too.
Yeah.
You be doing ollies?
No. I'm not like those skateboarders.
You go down to Dodge Park? You know where that's at?
Yeah, it's on the west side. I know where that is.
They got dudes over there be getting it, over at Dodge.
Yeah, these are big stuff.
We should go over there and take some time up Dodge Park.
Good luck with that. Something about Dodge Park. No, something about skaters in general. Like, we're aggressive.
Well, I know everybody over there anyway.
We're going to the skate park and the short park. It's a much better. It's fall, too.
Wait, are you talking about skating?
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, right by the airport?
No, short park, of course. Westfield.
Oh, I heard about that one. That's
nice. You can take your bikes on it. Yeah. Everything.
I know a lot of dudes. I know a lot of dudes who be in the BMX shit and they do the tricks and all that.
You go up there, you see all that. Yeah. You see the real professionals in there, actually.
Yeah.
I forgot you.
Chen.
So like Elijah Chen Mix. So you're Elijah.
Right.
Chen Mix.
Here's last
name is
Spence. Okay.
Bro, you got them on camera now. I'm going to have to delete it. They're going to look you up, bro.
I mean, the reason why, though, is because, like, Mira's nephew has a Facebook name, Elijah Chen Mix. Son. Elijah.
Bro.
And it's Chen.
Bro.
It's Elijah Chen Mix.
He knows it's a Chen. He's doing his mom here.
So you're just Elijah Chen.
For that
For real?
Yeah, I'm a chin. He's like, I'm a chin. My dad's a chin. You
know? He's like, oh, watch out for them motherfuckers.
So wait a minute, your life is not right.
Check out your boy, the scientist.
Hey, unless they got another daddy that I don't know about. You know? Because these women, that's how these women are, man.
That's
it
mom.
It says, the saying is, mama's baby, papa's maybe.
Mama's baby, papa's maybe.
That's all of us that got children, man. Unless you go and have an actual blood test, you can get this blood test, and you see that they're just showing us
fucking
hell. That's the kingdom we're living in, man. We're living under this oppression that our women.
And there's nothing you can do about it.
Or mamas, or sisters.
That's
or
my
mamas,
cousin you're talking about.
Or cousins.
That's my cousin you're talking
you
about.
Know, all these women are foul, man. All these women. All the women are foul. There are some women that do better, that try to do better, but all these women are foul, man. Ask any of these women that you look up to, ask them how many men they've been with.
If the answer ain't one. The answer should be one.
One or none.
That's a righteous woman is one.
One or none.
One or none. That's a righteous woman.
Right. Ask her. How many women you know play with?
Because a woman's virginity, you know, that's all supposed to be sacred. Marriage is supposed to be sacred. You know what I mean? That's something that people take it lightly now. Being married, that's just something that lasts for a couple months. You know what I mean? We have fun for a minute.
Oh yeah, you're right. Temporary love.
Yeah.
You know that temporary passion. People go and get
back,
married.
Back when we was in rulership before America.
Can I ask him?
Yeah. No.
You can ask anybody though.
No, because that's something disrespectful.
Man, yeah, it is.
You can smack. That's somebody you know.
Yeah.
Well, hell, go and do it. Ain't nothing wrong with
you. I mean, because there is forgiveness for a hoe though. Yeah. But that's very, it's very. It's not likely because they're not to be forgiven. You gotta ask for repentance. You gotta repent. You know what I mean? You gotta repent. And most of these hoes, in their mind, they didn't do nothing wrong. It was okay. That you know, to suck all those dicks and fuck all those dudes.
Be a porn star.
Be a porn because they had to do it to feed their baby.
Hey, wait.
They'll justify it.
Actually, not yet.
But like I said,
look at this big weird son bitch.
Right. Rape.
Your
rape.
Boy, though.
The word rape. Let's go into the word rape.
Okay, but
rape only means to
check out your boy.
That's what the word rape means. Rape isn't wrong. I know. I'm bugging out on this one. We got a clown for a second. We got a clown for a second. Now, Esau, you clowning.
Why are you clowning, bro?
Esau, you clowning.
No.
You are clowning.
You know what?
Hey, that look like Mr. Bean, bro. You remember Mr. Bean?
Oh, yeah. That was a Jake, though.
Oh, yeah, but Jake.
That was a Jake, though. That's a Jake, though.
Yeah, he was.
Mr. Bean was funny.
Yeah, Mr. Bean was that shit.
That's a heathen.
Why you walk out the house like that, bro? Right. Only a heathen would do
you
that.
You consciously put that shit on. I know he looked in the mirror.
He looked like Mr. Mitzelplex, bro. Yeah.
Bro.
You remember Mr. Mitzelplex?
Superman.
Yeah, that's your boy right there.
Oh, hell.
I know he looked in the mirror. I know he looked in the mirror and saw himself.
What the fuck?
My boyfriend's gonna like this one.
What the fuck?
Hell no.
My husband's.
Just when you
had a husband or boyfriend.
He definitely ain't got no woman.
I think that's number two, Buzz, but hurry up, back to rape.
I got a scripture.
Deuteronomy 22 and 28. If a man find a damsel that is a virgin, which is not betrothed,
a virgin is not betrothed.
Now this is what the Bible says.
It's not reading off of it. We're not on her. It's not his heart.
We're not coming out of our hearts and our opinion. It's what the Bible actually says.
They hold on her, and lie with her, and they confound her. Then that the man that lay with her shall give unto the damsel's father 50 shekels of silver, and she shall be his wife, because he hath humbled her.
Humbled her.
May not put away all his days.
Because before then, the possession of that female, that was the father's possession, he owned her, his daughter.
The woman of property.
So that's why the man went and gave the father some shekels. So to buy the father off. So,
yeah, he take care of the father.
I have to ask. Who takes it by father? Oh, no, they
most books tell you the author. It's like Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Ezekiel, Jeremiah. The first five books of the Bible was written by Moses.
Okay, I was going to say, man, there's a lot of
like the one he read was written by Moses.
Okay, that's the Old Testament, though.
What is
the New Testament?
Okay, it's the New Testament. Well, the New Testament, it says the same thing. Because the words of the Ten Commandments at? In the Old Testament. You know what I'm saying?
But I think killing's okay.
But listen, that rape man, you just can't snatch any woman, the rape man. And you can't do it now in this world. Because they have laws. The devil's protecting these women.
I don't think that was ever okay.
Well,
but it's not saying rape, but once you get with a woman, you can't just rape a bitch in the alley and leave her. So you gotta, you can't put her away. She has to be your wife until the end, so you die. Once you lay with a woman, according to the scriptures, you can't leave her. You gotta keep her.
That's your wife.
And you can have more than one wife.
That's your wife.
John 5.
It's just unusual to somebody who's been.
It was John 5.
John 5:45. Do not think that I will accuse you to the Father. There's one that accuses of you, even Moses, in whom you trust.
Keep going.
For had you believed Moses, you would have believed me, for he wrote of me.
He said, well, if you believe Moses, then you believe me. Because we was reading Moses' words.
But if you believe not his writings, how shall you believe my words?
Dang. Cut.
He wrote that, didn't he?
Yeah, of course.
That's bad.
He wrote Deuteronomy. Moses wrote first five books. They called it the Torah. The first five books, the Torah, which means law. The law. So that was the law. So they had a law for every instance that you could think of. There was a law that covered it. You know what I mean? But nowadays, according to the Bible, there's what, about 613 laws. That sounds like a lot, but it's not. In America, there's millions of laws. You'd have to go to college for 50 years and you still don't know a law.
I see.
To go to court, you got to pay thousands of dollars to get a lawyer. You know what I mean?
I seen on that show, Law and Order, the dude, he was like trying to make a case and trying to like prove it that the dude was wrong or whatever. So he had to go back to his room and there was like all these books and laws and try to look for a certain type of laws.
That's madness.
Books like this big each.
That's why this devil gonna be taken out of his place.
And essentially, they don't follow the laws. When you go to court, whoever pays, if you got enough money, you're just not gonna go to jail. You pay your way out of it. You know what I'm saying? You get that good lawyer, pay the court some good money, you get out. You know what I mean?
Especially
you get a bond.
Especially if you find an attorney that's good with the prosecutor and the judge.
Yep.
Because there are some that don't get
the favors. Because they're all the lawyers, the defense and prosecutors, when on their free time, they all hang out together. They go to the same club.
Masons.
They're all Masons. They're all part of the same secret societies, the fraternities.
Blowing each other.
Yeah, I mean, it's
blowing each other behind closed doors.
It's a
fine, like, you really,
it's a doing homosexual
of course.
Shit.
Yeah. But look, because to them, court is a game.
I wanted to be on court.
To them, you know, court is a game. Where do you play basketball at? On a court.
I don't play basketball.
Or tennis, you played on a court. What's a game? Tennis. You see what I'm saying?
That's why I read the scripture, man. Revelation 11:8.
I play tennis.
And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt.
Yeah, America is spiritually known as Sodom and Egypt. That's why there's a pyramid.
I thought it was Gomorrah.
Well, it is.
That's what he said.
Sodom, Gomorrah, same thing.
So, wait, Sodom would actually be like when someone says sodomizing, they're referring back to the place.
Well, that's why they get the word sodomite nowadays refers to a homosexual. Somebody who engaged in lewd sexual acts. That's a sodomite.
So, was Sodom basically destroyed for being homosexual?
Well, not just that for every manner of evil.
These motherfuckers making sweet love to their pit bull. Animals they had over there.
That dark side of the internet porn right there. I'm not kidding about that. I accidentally seen it one day.
Well, we done seen it all, bro.
Sodom.
We got the internet. We know what goes
Sodom.
On.
Sodom. We know.
Like 99% of the internet.
There's some shit I'd like to get back. I wish I didn't.
Oh, my God. No. But you know what? You can't do that.
You can't go back.
You're a witness.
A witness.
You're a judge.
Oh, you're a witness. You know? The Lord made it, so you're going to believe it.
That's the bitter of the scripture.
What
that's
they
the
say,
bitter.
Yeah,
that's the
bitter. That's the bitter.
You know?
Because seeing is believing.
I didn't like seeing that, man. I didn't see that. You know, I didn't see it. I was clowning on the comic board, but I actually seen a donkey kill a man fucking him to death. A donkey killed a man fucking him to death.
Are you talking about that one man, one horse? video?
Oh, I don't
know. There's a famous video.
That was a horse.
It's many.
And I accidentally seen that because someone decided, hey.
We brought that out before. That was a famous video.
Split him open.
Because he recorded himself live getting fucked by the horse.
He hit him hard. Pow! Split him open.
Damn.
Ooh, that's a horrible
one. But these bitches out here.
That's what he get. That's what he deserves.
They don't drink horse nut, though, you know, because they get paid a couple G's for that shoot. And they'll drink the horse nut, dog nut.
That's a delicacy in some countries.
And those videos are unlimited. I mean, it's like they go on forever and ever.
And not just.
You can watch a million videos with a different woman in each one.
These motherfuckers is pedophiles, too. They love boys, little boys.
Excuse me.
They love little boys. You know what I'm saying? And that's why it's called coming out now, because them devils love little boys. You know what I'm saying? They just love anything, man.
That's why all the congressmen always get
devils right there.
Dennis Hester, the former Speaker of the House, it just came out. He was one, the third most powerful man in the country. It came out that he was having sex with little boys and young men. You know what I'm saying? Then he tried to pay him off.
Shut up.
Well, Michael, bro, I mean. That's why Michael caught leprosy. The Lord cursed him. He turned from a black man to a white man. That's part of that curse.
Spiritually and physically. That's why he did.
That's a blessing, though.
That's why he was constantly taking them pain pills, staying high all the time. And he had doctors to get from. They knew going to say no to Michael. That's big money, man.
I said nothing, right?
Huh?
I said nothing, right? You really touched a guy without a nose.
He chopped that motherfucking nose off, didn't he?
He really didn't have a nose. He had a nose.
He's like, I ain't having no big ass nose.
That nigga had a nose at one time.
He chopped that motherfucker off.
I mean, seriously, though. I mean, he already looked dead. He died looking like this.
So that's why it was a blessing that the Lord took kill
him. Can you imagine a casket, man? Like, look. He's already looked dead, huh?
That's East Main.
You on the east side? That's good.
One and two. Oh, yeah, how long shall I cry and thou would not hear? Even cry unto thee of violence and thou would not say. Why dost thou show me iniquity? They cause me to be all weakness. The violence are before me, and they. There are that rise up, cries of contention. Therefore, the Lord slack. Judgment doth never go forth. For the wicked does compassion about the righteous. Therefore, wrong judgment.
Right, there's no judgment out here in America. Right. We compass by the wicked. You go down to the courthouse. When's the last time you've been to the courthouse? You ever been up in there? You go over that song, bitch, be packed. Shoulder to shoulder. Take a half hour just to get up in there.
Shit, how many floors is in there?
And they all up in there for some bullshit infractions. They didn't even commit no crime. You know what I mean? They just in there racking up the dollars.
I'm a happy. Thank
bro.
You.
Yep. All right, then.
I'll tell your son done. You said what's up?
Talk to your house yesterday.
Hey, what are you guys creating to get back on this?
Oh, sir, I ain't
got anything. Yeah, I ain't got shit on. I just spent all my change the other day. The whole last week, I was surviving on a quarter of a nickel. He was with me before I was throwing pennies in the thing, bro. I'm going to spend my pennies. They try to say you ain't allowed to spend pennies. Bullshit. I'll spend every last one of them, bro. I don't care if I hold up the whole line. You're going to count them, motherfucker. Yeah, it's like, shit, this is all the money I got. Pennies. I'm a spender. 100 pennies to a bottle of water, bro.
All right, then, with that, Shalawam, we about to get up out of here.